brought to you by...
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Welcome back from that break. Well, in case you're just joining us, we are into the home stretch. Yes, the final part of the show. You are watching Game On, and certainly it's nothing but the biggest stories when it comes to outdoor sports. But quickly, from the local stories, let's now talk a bit of basketball, because the world of sports, not just basketball itself, continues to mourn the passing of the five-time NBA champion, that is Kobe Bryant, and one of his long-term friends, and also one of the best names in the sport of basketball, that is LeBron James. Yesterday, or a couple of hours ago, I did take to his social media platforms to pen down a very emotional message, where he also went on to promise that he'll continue the legacy that was left behind by the one and only, that is Kobe Bryant, who that is a couple of days ago, I did perish in a helicopter crash in there, together with eight other people that were actually on board. Everyone has been waiting for Kobe, for LeBron James actually to come out with a statement. And he spoke about so many different things. Mm. And he's promised that he'll keep the legacy that Kobe Bryant left building, especially at the LA Lakers going forward.
In fact, I saw from the website, the news coming from the NBA was that they are pleading if it's possible to put his name on the logo of Lakers, you know, as a way of trying to pay tribute to him and appreciate him. Because the fact that these two, the game of LA and was called off, it clearly tells you how much the world is still mourning. Up to now, if you go on the various Twitter handles, like as we shall be going to the story of tennis, we shall tell you the story between Nadal and his colleague, how the colleague came while he was entering, was wearing the Kobe Bryant jersey. So sure, it's something that we're still mourning. So we still continue mourning, but death has happened. We have nothing to do about that.
All right, still speaking the Kobe Bryant legacy, it's actually been confirmed that the game between the LA Lakers and the LA Clippers that should actually have been played today has been rescheduled to a later date. And this is pretty much to allow the community in Los Angeles to continue mourning. We've seen so many teams and so many games actually being halted. I saw the game between the Toronto Raptors and the Spurs. Both teams had to take a 24-second shot clock violation just to pretty much pay homage and pay respect to the fallen soldier. And you're thinking it's bad times, but you know, sport, not just basketball, everyone, like you mentioned, tennis as well, have all come together and pretty much celebrated life. I lost under very, you know, unfortunate circumstances. But ultimately, like they say, the legend lives on, Kobe Bryant.
I don't know why most of our footballers in the world have not come out to mourn with him or to celebrate his life, apart from a few like the Lionel Messi, that at least we saw his tweet. Probably because he was a fan of Kobe and Kobe was his fan anyway. But putting fact as a fact as constant, so many fans around the world and sports other sports actors, especially the athletes, are coming out. So one, what can we do in such a case? Me, I would suggest if we would have every year we do a memory, like in all sports, it can be an association. Because by the way, it's thanks to God that basketball is under IOC, International Cricket Committee,
Olympic Committee.
Sorry. So I think as we go to Tokyo 2020, as we go to Tokyo this 2020, I am suggesting that we should have that moment of silence and a particular moment for Kobe Bryant, especially for the basketballers, people who love basketball and the sport at large.
All right, may the soul of the departed, together with the eight others that perished in the, you know, crash, rest in peace. But quickly, I am from basketball now. Let's talk a bit of tennis, because a big win for the 19-time Grand Slam winner, that is Rafael Nadal, famously known as the King of Clay, has went on to steamroll, that is Nick Kyrgios, to move into the next round of that is tennis, actually, when it comes to the first Grand Slam over there, which is the Australian Open. That was not the only win, but we also got to see Roger Federer picking up a very interesting win against the main man, that is the American Tennis Sandgren, to move into the next round. This one, though, had to go for the decider, because he won the first set, he dropped the second and the third sets before he bounced back and won the fourth in a decider, and ultimately went on to edge the fifth set as well. So the two big names, Roger Federer, Rafael Nadal are through. Novak Djokovic will be in the running. We speak of names like Dominic Thiem in there, who is in the running. Alexander Zverev, the German, is also in the running for the quarterfinals. Before we even get to speak, the women were some of the big names, including Simona Halep won the US Open last year. Names like Muguruza Gabrin as well is in the running to get into the semi-finals. But for the men, there's not been that much of a change of guard, because we speak the big three, Roger Federer, Rafael Nadal, yes, and definitely Novak Djokovic. And exactly, most of them are picking up some big wins. Though, the interesting thing about Federer is that he's yet to play one of the seeded guys, because everyone he's been playing has been unseeded. And there's a possibility he could actually play Novak Djokovic in the semis.
Well, I would want to see instead to see him play against Nadal, not Novak Djokovic.
Probably
not
in the finals.
Probably in the finals, and because I'm a very big fan of Nadal, but I try to watch a little bit of replay of Nadal's game. If they happen to meet in the finals again, it would be one of the best Grand Slams you'd ever want to have in the world. So having these big shots, it's not something that has come on a silver plate. It's something that they've been working on. And you know, pedigree.
Yeah.
You cannot beat pedigree. You cannot beat statistics. These guys have built themselves up. I was trying also to watch the game of the one of Nadal against Zakarias, and they had a lot of exchange. I would not want to use a very rough word on air here. One was calling the other, "You were salty something," and then the other one was saying, Nadal was telling Zakarias that he's ill-mannered, he has no manners.
Yep.
And then the other one is saying, "You're salty." So I this grudge started right way back from last year. So sometimes for us, we think it is only in football that we normally have this kind of banters or probably this kind of grudges and hooliganism. It's now going all over, world over, because they even reach a point of Zakarias attacked the umpire. So you can see how tense it was. But for him, as Nadal being a senior in the game, it took the advantage to see that he crosses over.
Yeah.
But there's a more likely chance of seeing Nadal and Federer meet in the finals.
All right, later this particular afternoon, Kontaveit will be up against Simona Halep. That is in the women's singles quarterfinals. Gabriel Muguruza will take on, that is Polinchikova. That will be later this afternoon in the quarterfinals. And that is for the women. For the men, though, there will be two quarterfinals after, you know, we did get to see the wins for Rafael Nadal and Roger Federer. And including the main man, that is Stan Wawrinka, who will be up against the German Alexander Zverev. So that is tennis for you. The Australian Open does continue to unfold. But quickly, away from tennis now, let's talk a bit of football, because Mikel Arteta was quite impressed with his Arsenal side last night as they went on to pick up a comfortable 2-1 win at the Vicarage Road against Bournemouth, which means that they ultimately progress into the fifth round of the FA Cup, where they are set for a trip away to Portsmouth. We actually had the draws yesterday for the fifth round, and we expect some big matchups. Whoever wins the replay, that includes Chelsea, will certainly be coming up against Liverpool. So expecting some big games to look out for as we head into the fifth round of the FA Cup. But Arteta, it looks like his team is starting to take shape, and he had so many of the kids out there yesterday. Two first half goals, one from Saka, the other from Eddie Nketiah. There was a late consolation for Bournemouth, but even then, quite comfortable at the end of the day.
At the end of the day, I think it's time that you're seeing philosophy of Arsenal of trusting many young players on board is coming back, because it started way back. Arteta knows it very well, how Wenger trusted them when they were young. So, and today's football is now evolving. Football is now for people, especially players who are below the age of 30, 28 there. That's the age that a footballer is very, very active. So I think that's the Nketiah, seeing the performance of Nketiah, yes. However, the very big challenge we are having, news coming out of Arsenal's camp, is Aubameyang could be on his way to Barcelona. And Arsenal is probably asking for over £50 million that should have been given to Arsenal. But if I were Arsenal at the moment, if I were Arteta, I think I would insist that Aubameyang should stay, because Aubameyang still needs one more season to groom these young players. Because his exit right now is going to cause a lot of havoc in goal scoring. Because all of a sudden, they've been struggling. That is a mere fact. But even besides scoring, I think they've improved a lot. You see people like Guendouzi winning a lot of balls there. You see people like Granit Xhaka trying to improve a little bit there. So, Arteta has it all it takes. Next season is going to be a better one for him.
One of the biggest challenges for his predecessor, Unai Emery, was creating a philosophy, a brand of football that the kids were actually playing through. We've seen the Arsenal team of late. There's a blend of both the young and the experienced.
Yes.
We're seeing a bit of a high intensity, pressing kind of game. should we start to think that Arteta is putting the pieces together?
Yes.
And now that they're into the fifth round of the FA Cup, could they go on and clinch the title because they're also the most successful team in this tournament?
Yes. In fact, Arteta's success goes way back to the dressing room. Mm. Because I remember the game they came and drew in Premier League against Chelsea. Mm. What he told the boys in the dressing room, please go and play for yourselves and play for Luis. When Luis was suspended in that game. So it basically means there's something that he borrowed from Arsenal. He's a former coach who mentored him so much to be one of the best in the world we had. We'll talk about from Spain. Mm. So for me, I think that pedigree, that kind of transmission with him and the players is something that is helping so much.
Yeah.
And because he doesn't have anything more or anything less. I mean, the players are developed by himself. So yes, he has got something better. And for me, I think FA, people should look out for Arteta's name in the finals.
All right, finally, before we get to go, guys, the EFL Cup does return for the semi-finals this evening. Tomorrow, there'll be a Manchester derby, Man City with a 3-1 advantage against Manchester United. But later this evening, down at the Villa Park, Aston Villa will be welcoming Leicester City. Both sides had to share the spoils in the first leg. Leicester City needed a late goal from Kelechi Iheanacho in the first leg to make sure that they had something to fight for as they headed down to the Villa Park. Do you remember Aston Villa did manage to knock out Liverpool at the quarterfinals after Jurgen Klopp put out what so many people believed was a weekend side for his quarterfinal. Quickly, as wrap up, Sharon, it's Aston Villa up against Leicester. Whoever picks up an aggregate win this evening moves into the finals and will play the winner between Man City and Manchester United.
I think I would go for Leicester.
Leicester City.
Yes. I still have the fact that I still trust them, their pedigree up front. And the fight is so, so hard. Hmm. So for me, if you
and
compare...
Vardy's back.
Yes, Jamie Vardy being back is one of the players that I enjoy watching so much up front there in the pitch. So I still go for Leicester City.
There's a Tanzanian, Bwana Sabata, recently signed for Aston Villa. Could be in line to make his big start up front, joined by players like Jack Grealish in this Aston Villa team.
Surprisingly, I am East African, yes, but again, sometimes when it comes to issues of who is good to the other, Mbwana Samata alone cannot make something very good for Aston Villa. Well, however, I would wish him good. I would want to see him, even if Aston Villa doesn't win today, but I would want to see him supersede and get some good statistics there and make some good headlines to prepare him for the future purposes coming ahead of him.
Okay, certainly that is the EFL Cup for you. Action does get returned this evening. That being said, that also brings us to the end of Game On today. I want to say many, many thanks to everyone that has been watching out there. Do you remember the Harvest Money Expo does get kickoff? That is February the 14th. We'll be running all the way up until the 16th of next month. And interest is 20,000 shillings. This comes to the training, but if you pay 10,000 shillings, it comes without training. And this fee is actually payable at the gate, starting at 8 a.m. So you can book a stall today. What you need to do is call the number. That is 0772-354-940. That is 0772-354-940. And do remember, the Harvest Money Expo will be happening in Nambole. Yes, that is at the Mandela National Stadium. It's sponsored by Abbey Development Limited, Engso, Champrisa International, DFCU Bank, Akfo International, Musubi Farm, and it's organized by The New Vision in partnership with the Embassy of the Netherlands. But hey, from myself and Sharon, we're saying many thanks for your company. If you want to place a bet this evening, you need to check out OneXBet because they've got the best offers. And it's not just about football, but it's about sports in general. And we'll see you back here tomorrow. From myself and the team, it's a wrap.
Game on. It's game on. We are big on sports. Big on sports.
Game On is brought to you by
Winning has never been this simple. Bet with 1xBet.